How's the front?
Yeah, it's really good. It's hot and sour. It's got an amazing flavor to it, and I really love it.
Pretty good, and you really love it, is it?
Yes, it's really nice. I'm at Vizag right now, and it's a very clean and beautiful city.
Wait. We gotta give them a proper intro.
Okay.
Like a bloody good intro.
Okay.
So what's up, guys? This is Sharon Zakaria. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. And we are right now at Visakhapatnam in Andhra Pradesh, and we are heading to a place which we're going to talk about pretty soon. So let's keep there as a suspense here, because this is my first international travel, and we have a connecting flight at Visakhapatnam. We came from Bangalore and we just landed. We collected our baggage. The baggage is right there, and we're at the restaurant inside the airport. We just stopped by for some soup and stuff because we are hungry. And our flight is at around 10 p.m. and it's about 7:30 right now. So we're about five of us traveling in total. And just so that you all know, this is Franklin.
Hey.
A very good friend of mine. We've been friends for about 10 years now.
10 years easy.
10 years easy. We started
from
tuitions.
Tuitions, yes.
From 10th standard. From 10th grade. So that's how we know each other. So
from the time we copied each other's
answers from, and papers
answers and
everything.
From papers and stuff, yeah.
Yeah. So that's how it all started, and all of a sudden he just calls me and he's like, you know, let's do a good international trip. So like, yeah, why not? Let's do it. So we're going to a particular place for a particular event. If you're following me on Instagram, you all will definitely know what it's about and what we're doing. I mean, that's something, you know, I never thought I would do in my entire life.
We're going to keep that suspicious a bit.
We're going to keep that suspense a little bit now. So let's hold on for the end of the video, probably the next video, so you all know what the event is. So before all of that, we're about five guys traveling in the whole and on the whole. So two of us are together because we're the same flight. Everyone's traveling in different flights. And a friend of ours, and the best part is, I don't know anyone else apart from Franklin. I actually met them yesterday while exchanging currency. At the Forex. So everyone seems to be all excited and pumped about the trip, because it's probably like, you know, it's most of their first international trips as well, you know, just like mine. Franklin's already been to Sri Lanka alone, that he went on a backpacking tour all by himself, and he spent about a good week or so.
Yes.
And he had a ball of a time there, that's what he says. So I'm really glad that he did that, because, you know, you go out, you venture out alone, and that's something that you really, really like, and, you know, you get to see.
I really found my soul in Sri Lanka. And that's when I saw Sharon's message on Instagram, and Sharon was like, why didn't you take me to Sri Lanka? And then I was like, don't worry, bro, we'll travel again, and probably your first international trip would be with me and a couple of my friends. So yeah, he's here, and I'm really pumped up as well to, you know, go to this place. Which we will be revealing to you in the next video.
The entire tenure of the trip is going to be about 10 days, which is going to be two different countries apart from India. So it's going to be an amazing journey. It's going to be a lot of things to see, a lot of new things to see, a lot of new people to meet, and some insane stuff that we're going to experience. And y'all are definitely going to experience that with us.
Oh, I can't wait to taste the food. Oh my God, we're going to taste all kind of food in the city. I'm going to freak out on food probably. You know, mouth-watering food, yeah.
You're gonna see all of that, don't worry about it. So, talking with the other three guys, that's David, Derek and Alan. Derek and Alan are supposed to be traveling tonight from Bangalore. It's at around 10:30. And David's flight is apparently 3:30 a.m. today. And he happened to go to the airport at 3:30 p.m. And that's when he realized that, you know, that he has missed his flight.
Yeah. So what happened was AirAsia actually gave him a flight initially at 2:30 in the afternoon, and then they rescheduled it to 3:45. He didn't know if it was 3:45 in the morning or 3:45 in the evening. I guess it's his first international trip too, so he wasn't aware of the what was happening. And he reached at the airport, and unfortunately the flight had already left. So he called us up. He wanted to travel with us, but then there was no tickets available. He'll be traveling at 11 today with the other guys who's coming with us. So yeah, wishing him luck too.
So he was supposed to be the first one to get there, and he already booked a stay for one night before, because just so he can go park his ass and, you know, get some good sleep. But it all happens that, you know, we are supposed to be reaching first, and probably that's how it was meant to be. So we're going to get there first, and I think, you know, we have about 2.5 hours left for our check-in, you know, for our boarding and everything. Soup here.
It's very delicious. The soup is very delicious.
Yeah.
I thank the chefs over here for making the food. One of the chefs are actually staring at us right now, but thanks again for the amazing food I've already been having.
So I still have to dig into it, so I still haven't started. I'm super hungry, and I did not eat lunch because of Franklin. He kept, you know, staring at his phone. I don't know what he was doing this phone, probably texting his whoever.
No, I was just posting stuff on Instagram about my travel stories.
Yeah, for
well.
Like 2 hours straight. Yeah. So that's about it, guys. So we're going to get done with this. We're going to wait, warm our asses up, and we're going to board the next flight and get to our destination, and I cannot wait.
So cannot wait for this.
Hold on for the remainder, for the rest of it. So we just got our dinner. Time's about 8:30, and Franklin's belting some
amazing biryani. All the way from Bangalore, I've been trolling about Andhra biryani. Whereas in Bangalore, I'll be searching for Andhra biryani and all that. So I'm very happy to have some Andhra cuisine in Andhra Pradesh. Let's have the first bite.
And I've ordered some non-veg combo. So it's got like one roti and some plain rice and some dal, some chicken curry, and some raita with some vegetables cut there. So let's see how it tastes. Good. How's it been?
It's good.
Hmm?
It's good.
I expected.
It's not as spicy as I expected it to be, but I like it. It's different from what we have in Bangalore, what they call as Yandra biryani and sell it.
Hyderabadi biryani,
whatever. But as far as this biryani, I'm going for it. I'm all in for it.
So a quick sneak peek at where we are going to.
Yeah.
You could probably, you know, take a screenshot or pause the video to see where I'm going. I'll flash it once again. So that's where we're heading to. My mind's busy on the phone as usual. I don't know why everyone who I travel with are always busy on the phone. They're always on calls, they're always on the phone, texting or doing something. I don't know why. And everyone's just sitting and not doing anything. Probably like, you know, trying to vlog, or I'm just the only one who vlogs. My friends, you know, on their phone, you know, who stuck on the phone. I don't know why, it's always me. So either which ways, waiting, I'm super excited. It's going to be my first ever international flight, guys, and I can't wait. I see you got a new cap.
Yes, I got this for a purpose, bro. I'm here to support.
So probably now we all know where we are at. So we just reached our destination, our final destination for the next 4 days. And we landed and we just took up, collected our baggage. And we're waiting for the rest of us here. So it so happens that Franklin has seen a couple of Koreans, I suppose. Wear the VR46 cap and the t-shirt, and he ends up doing all of this. We are at Kuala Lumpur right now, and we're heading to Sepang for the MotoGP Grand Prix, which is going to be Valentino Rossi's 401st Grand Prix, 401st race rather. And we're waiting for the rest of them. All three of them on the same flight, they're on their way, they're about to land probably in about the next 10 minutes. So once we're done with that, we'll probably be, you know, heading to the hotel and checking in. And I'll probably show you the hotel too, because we've got a kick-ass place booked for us. It's called the Noon Platinum Suites, which is very close to the Petronas Twin Towers and the KL Tower. So I'm super excited to get there. It's got a rooftop pool as well, and it is going to be absolutely stunning. So I'll see you all quickly on the road. I don't know what he is up to. They're going to bump into them, watch out, they're changing diapers.
I'm just waiting to see Rossi, because I myself will start riding this trolley wherever I go.
So just because you're wearing a 46 cap, it doesn't mean you're Valentino Rossi.
These trolleys actually got brakes and stuff.
You got a security coming towards us. Watch out.
So this is how it works.
Yeah. I'm sure people have seen that at the airport. I don't know what he's up to. That's his take. No, that is his take on trying to wait for David, Alan, and
Derek.
Alright, guys, so we did not get to see any of the boys. They got off at a different terminal, and they took a cab and left because it was too far to walk from their terminal to ours. So me and Franklin just got ourselves a cab from this app called Grab. It's more like your...
I can't wait to go see the place that we're gonna stay. Yeah. It's gonna be like amazing.
Yeah, so Grab is something
amazing.
Like your... So Grab is something like your Ola and Uber that we have in Bangalore. So we just got a cab through that. I don't know what this car is. I don't know what the company is. Anyway, it doesn't matter because it's spacious, it's good. And we are in the beautiful city of Kuala Lumpur. And this is how the road from the airport towards the city looks like. It's basically a 60 kilometer drive from the airport to the stage that we are heading to. Man, this is like my first time off the country, off the coast of India, so it's amazing. Guys, check it out. There's a toll booth similar to how it is in India. But I don't think there's anyone. Oh yeah, there is someone who collects the toll fee. There's nothing like FastTag or anything here as such. But there is something here on this car. Oh yeah. It's a card that he used. He just tapped on it and just passed by. It's something like a FastTag, but it's like a debit card in your hand, like something with a sensor chip in. And he just touched that device and instantly it opened and he left. Brilliant.
Pretty cool.
Yeah, damn cool. Finally, oh my god, what a lovely view, guys.
Whoa.
No, 2004 was the tallest building in the world. Yep. Oh, Macha, that's our stay. Fine, that's our stay.
That's our stay
there. show you all where we're going to actually be staying for the next 4 days. And look at this building. Wow. Dude, what's this, dude?
Yeah, what the hell? This one.
This one? So this is where we are going to be staying for the next 4 days.
I can't believe we booked this property. Bro, I can't believe we booked this property. Yeah, I'm so happy about it. It's right opposite the Twin Towers, you know? It's like it's amazing. I just can't wait to go and have a look at the Twin Towers from the Infinity
Pool
right there on top.
She's actually wondering, what the hell is this guy doing? Oh my god, dude, this is our hotel. So the place we booked is called the Platinum Suites. It's called the Face Suites as well. It's called Deep Blue Tangerine. Man, look at that. What a view, man. Platinum Suites as well, so, and we're right now at the 18th floor. We've come to the office of the suites owner. So we've kept a luggage here because our check-in time is at 1 p.m. The time right now is 9:30, so we're just going to go down and hang out in the lobby, or just go out for a walk or have some breakfast and get back. And the rest of them still haven't made it here, man. So we've been waiting for a good 5 minutes for the lift and we still haven't walked any, so we're just walking.
Because it's got 50 floors in it.
It's got 52 floors.
52
the
floors.
Pool, the swimming pool is at the 52nd floor. I think we're at the 34th or 38th floor.
Yes.
That's what she said. I'm waiting to check in and show you all the room. And the place is mad. Oh, finally, you're
the bags on top.
When you guys reach here?
Oh, man, it's been about half an hour.
Where are you guys doing?
finally, the boys have arrived.
Don't keep your luggage at top.
Alright, guys, this is our hotel. This is where we're staying at. The boys are there, right there.
Yeah, there.
We just dropped the bags. Now we just dropped the bags at the hotel. Oh my god, look at that.
Whoa, that's what I want to go on the double decker, dude.
The coach, fuck, it was an open decker, much, huh?
Yeah, it's damn neat.
Oh man, what buildings, dude. This is more like an important square at Raja Abdullah Road, or the street that you call it. And I can't take my eyes off the hotel building. Boys, where are we at?
Adonis Towers, Malaysia.
Adonis Towers.
Julie Asia.
Okay, you can see the KL Tower there.
That's the KL Tower, yeah.
It's beautiful. What an amazing place to be at, guys. We're finally all five of us together. It's an absolute amazing experience. Finally, everyone's here.
Ready. We made it.
Probably after 13 hours of the journey, we're together, yeah. Yeah, David took about 24 hours to get here.
Yeah, I think you know David's story by now.
The building's absolutely ridiculous. Let's check this out, guys. Freak. We found a couple of Muslim street food, yeah. The stalls are up to the side of the road. And you can see there's some fresh fruit juice being made. I think that's lemon and that's more like a mojito. Real mangoes.
What no one is putting up the stalls. I think we came too early. You bell. Hey, that's a plastic.
No, they came and ended
my grandfather, what he did once, you know, he belt. This was on the dining table, okay? The wax fruits.
He's too old, man. He lost his memory a lot. He started building this wax fruit stuff.
Oh, shit. Sad. This is starting, huh?
Okay, let's just walk up.
So, guys, this is where I'm ending my first vlog to Malaysia. And we're just heading out for breakfast right now. So, you'll probably see all of that. We're going to try some good local, authentic Malaysian street food for breakfast. Or let's see if we get to some other place. So, we're going to take the monorail to get a dog. So, this is where I'm going to end the video right now. Thank you so much for watching this video. Do like, share, and subscribe if you like the content. And trust me, you have 9 or 10 videos remaining for the series. And you're going to have a beautiful time watching it. And it's going to be absolutely lovely because the places that we're going to cover is absolutely stunning. It's going to be 4 days in Malaysia. And the rest of the days is going to be in another country, which you all will know very soon. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. Do subscribe, share, and comment. And like my videos. And keep supporting me to do more and to give you all more. Thank you so much for watching the video. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.